Our Christians in Iraq have faced persecution for decades. U.S. military forces have protected Christians, but the recent exit from Afghanistan has caused concern about what may happen to religious minorities if the U.S. also leaves Iraq. Nobel Peace Prize nominee Juliana Taimoorazy and the Iraqi Christian Relief Council worked to protect Christians and called on President Biden this week to continue the U.S. presence in Iraq. And joining us now is Juliana Taimoorazy, founder and president of the Iraqi Christian Relief Council and a Nobel Peace Prize nominee. Juliana, great to be with you, and congratulations on your nomination.
Thank you so much. It's an honor to be here, and it's an honor for me to be nominated for the tremendous work that my organization has done in Iraq and in the region.
First off, can you tell us a little bit more about your organization and what inspired you to do this work? I know you have a personal connection.
Absolutely. I was born and raised in Iran as an Assyrian, and I was smuggled out of Iran in 1989, and we came to the States in 1990. So I understand harassment and religious persecution and also living as a refugee. We founded the Iraqi Christian Relief Council in 2007 after speaking with Cardinal Francis George, the late Cardinal Francis George of Archdiocese of Chicago, when I inquired about how the Vatican can be more involved and help the Christians of Iraq. And they advised me to start this apostolate to be able to raise awareness among my American brothers and sisters and tell them what the Christians of Iraq's needs are and who we are as a people.
And Juliana, for those who may not be that familiar, can you talk to us about the history of Christians in Iraq, what life is like for them now, and the challenges they face?
Absolutely. The history of Iraqi Christians, or the Assyrians, who are also known as Chaldean and Syriac, is really 6,700 years. The first library was founded by King Ashurbanipal in Nineveh, which is today's Mosul. And as you know, Jonah went to Nineveh to preach to the Ninevites to turn to the Hebrew God. And Iraq really is known as the Second Holy Land because of all the biblical activities that have happened there. So the Assyrians, the Chaldeans, the Syriacs in Iraq, the Christians of Iraq, have come under persecution, really starting from the beginning when we converted to Christianity through St. Thomas the Apostle. And it became more intense after the rise of Islam. Starting with the U.S. invasion, our population was 1.5 million. Today, we only have 150,000 people left. People have left this country. Many have been killed. A lot of them are still living as refugees in the region, in Lebanon, Turkey, and Jordan. And something that people don't talk much about is the trauma that has been inflicted, not just since 2003 with the rise of radical Islam in Iraq, with al-Qaeda's finding its safe haven in Iraq, and then with the pulling of the troops in 2011, which gave a breeding ground for ISIS to come with a vengeance back to Iraq, because it was before Islamic State of Iraq, ISI. So we really have suffered for centuries, not just since 2003. For example, the Armenian genocide, the Assyrian people fell to the sword, along with the Armenians and Greeks. So for us, you talked about President Biden, the letter that we've written to him. Really, we would like to raise awareness about what happened just now in Afghanistan. And as a result of that, the entire region will be affected. And one more genocide, one more massacre towards my people and the Yazidi community, which is the other minority community in Iraq. That will be the end of Christianity. That will be the end of indigenous people of Iraq, which is the Assyrians, Chaldeans, and Syriacs, and also the Yazidis.
Yeah, and I was going to ask you why you felt that was so important. Also, I'm wondering, are there other countries that are supportive of the Christian communities in Iraq?
In the region, we have Jordan. Jordan is a great ally of ours. They have housed many of our refugees there, and they are treated well. Turkey is a little bit more difficult because, as you know, with the Armenian, Assyrian, Greek genocide, the number of the Assyrian people, the Christian community has dwindled down, especially the Assyrian community. It's only 25,000 people. Iran, when I was growing up in Iran, we had over 80,000 people. Today, we only have 7,000 left. Syrian Christian numbers have dwindled in Lebanon as well. In the West, since ISIS was dismantled in 2017, although they're back, you know, wreaking havoc again, getting organized again in Iraq. But the two countries that really stepped up to help were Hungary and Poland, and then United States, thanks to Vice President Pence, they reorganized, they regrouped, and they sent aid to Iraq. But really, what ISIS did to my people on the ground in Iraq and to the Yazidis, they decimated our numbers. They obliterated our cities, and we're still trying to recover. And that's what my organization does. We travel across the country. We speak about the atrocities committed against the Christians in Iraq. We raise funds and we send it for food, shelter, medicine. That is extremely needed, especially now with COVID.
Well, Juliana, thank you so much for your time today. Thank you for what you do, and congratulations again on your nomination. God bless you.
I appreciate it. God bless you. Thank you so much for having me on.